Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000, and I don't know why I'm doing this, I just felt like playing that. I know I've already LP'd Super Metroid on this channel, but this isn't just Super Metroid, this is another kind of Super Metroid that I've also already done on this channel. This is a randomizer, randomized Super Metroid. Control setting mode, item selected, set to that, angle R, angle down, yep. I always switch select and Y on the controls because I don't like reaching over to select to change my weapon. He's gonna kick my ass while I'm sitting here trying to change my weapon. So yeah, this is Super Metroid Randomized. I'm just playing through it because I felt like I saw Super Metroid in my recent ROMs on this emulator and I was like, you know, I want to play some Super fucking Metroid, you know? And this emulator is pretty reliable when it comes to recording goodly, so I trust I'll be able to do it. I'm not going for like a speed run here. I might just record this whole thing in one go, in one big long video, which could take an incredibly long time, but I'm probably gonna put this up on Saturday anyway, which is like when a long video like that would go up. I might split it if it turns out to just be like too astronomically humongous. Hey baby Metroid, does anybody else when they get to this part always try to line up Samus's arm cannon perfectly with the edge of the... There we go, like that. Trying to line up the arm cannon perfectly with the edge of the canister that the baby Metroid is in. I always try to do that. Hey Ridley, what's up? Man, I really want to play Samus Returns because that came out recently, but I don't have a 3DS because I lost my 3DS in June. Man, I'm so fucking mad. Every single time I think about that, I just like I'll think about that when I'm trying to go to sleep, and I'll like stay up for an extra 20 minutes like beating myself up over it for being such an idiot to have lost that fucking thing. Especially considering we absolutely can't afford, I can't afford, and neither can anybody around me afford one as a gift or anything. It's like, jeez. Just one more thing compounding the smorgasbord of fuck going on in life right now. I got too much shit to worry about without also having to worry about missing out on a whole bunch of 3DS games I've been waiting for God knows how long, because I lost my 3DS like an idiot. Like Super Metroid Samus Returns, I haven't played Pokemon Sun and Moon, I never finished Pokemon Sun and Moon, Ever Oasis, man, I was looking forward to Ever Oasis since it was revealed. And now, like, and then I lost my 3DS like less than 2 months before it was released. I was so fucking mad. And there's those new Kirby games too. Like, geez, like Blowout, whatever, and Battle Royale I'm not super into, but hopefully we can get a Switch here sometime soon. I can not miss out on Kirby Star Allies, because that game looks totally awesome. It really bums me out. I don't know what it is recently, but Kirby seems to have been catching a lot of flack recently just for being a popular series that gets a lot of love by Nintendo. Like, that's literally the only reason. It's because people are sick of seeing so many new Kirby games when, like, the series they love don't get as many. Especially because a lot of the Kirby games recently have used the same engine and the same style. But the way I see it, the only reason Kirby games have quote-unquote stagnated, which I don't like using that word because it implies negativity, the only reason Kirby games have supposedly stagnated, well, I mean, I'll just say it. The only reason Kirby games have stagnated recently is because when they came out with Kirby's Return to Dream Land, they discovered the formula for perfect Kirby. They perfected it with Return to Dream Land, so they haven't needed to make a new formula. You know? So anyway. Yeah, I don't know, it really just drives me crazy that people, I mean, especially since, like, I've said the same thing about Fire Emblem for a long time. Like, how many games do people need of Fire Emblem? I mean, I know, like, saying that instantly makes me a hypocrite, but it just drives me crazy that people just get all over Kirby, which is, like, the most inoffensive game series on the fucking planet. They get all up in its grill for having too many games. For its fans are too happy. We want them to be less happy so they can be like us who get less games. But nobody says the same thing about Fire Emblem. I mean, I guess that ship kind of sailed with the whole Smash Bros. Thing. You know, people got that out of their system when 500 Fire Emblem newcomers came to Smash Bros. You know?
Why did it give me the morph ball there? I did set the randomizer setting to casual, so because I didn't remember exactly what everything else actually entailed. Because who knows what that would have been, really. What do we got here? Super missiles. Cool. Yeah. But yeah, like, it's really annoying because, I mean, it's like, yeah, I don't want to sound like a broken record here, but Fire Emblem, like, what the hell, man? They were getting new games, like, yearly releases with whole new stories, and like, people say Kirby doesn't have a story, but it totally does. You just have to actually look for it. It's like the game doesn't handhold you through the story. You have to actually look for the story yourself, which games don't really do anymore very much. Games used to do that more. You know, they would have. Well, I don't know. There wasn't really a time where games started or stopped doing that. You know, when somebody says, "Oh, games don't hand game," when somebody brings up the idea of a game's not handholding you as much, the instant assumption is that they're talking about the good old days. You know, the old days where games were filled to the brim with tutorials and junk. Oh, I didn't even realize they had power bombs. That's gonna come in very handy. I can go down here and get whatever's down here. Miscals. Oh, I should have gotten, well, I'm definitely gonna go see. Well, I should have seen what was in the ceiling down there before. Because in regular Super Metroid, there's an energy tank down in blue Brinstar that I always try to pick up as soon as possible. Just because it's convenient to have. But, anyway. It's weird that this area is actually part of Brinstar, but it's presented as more of a part of Criteria that just so happens to be connected to Brinstar. You know, because the music here that plays is Criteria Underground. Anyway. Yeah. But yeah, it just really bums me out. I'll think about that. Oh, damn, it's the fucking Various suit. Holy shit. Okay, that's definitely worth sequence breaking for. Holy crap. This is turning out to be, like, possibly one of the luckiest. Dude, you're supposed to leave one of those guys alive. What the hell is wrong with you? Are you on Minute Maid or something? This has turned out to be one of the luckiest runs of the randomizer I've ever had. Like, I'm not even 10 minutes in, and I already have missiles, super missiles, and power bombs, and I'm about to pick up the Various suit. Like, what? Okay, now let's kill this guy. Pick up the missile pack because I wanted to pick it up. It's not really a complicated thing. Okay, so stand here. Get that guy to scroll on screen. Yep. Son of a bitch! You motherfucker! I shot that thing like a split second too early. What a pain! What a dick cheese! Ugh! I tried to save it though. You saw it. I tried to save it. You know, this kind of makes me want to play. Actually, do you always jump that high? It feels like, yeah, you always jump that high. Man, you never really realize how high Samus jumps until, well, I guess until you look at it. Dude, what the hell, man? That totally should have knocked me into the Various suit. I'm gonna do this. You know, this is gonna happen. I don't care if it takes me 10 minutes. Because this is a casual, randomized run. I'm not in this for the money. I'm not in this for the fame. I'm not in this for your games. I'm in this to have a fun time playing Super Metroid Randomized. And if that means picking up the Various suit before I even go to Green Grinstar, then so much the better. There we go. Various suit. Ha 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 ha. Bingo! Oh! I wonder if I could make it into this. Because I can actually get up into this area up here. Oh. Dude. And I just need to. No. You have to do the somersault. Got up. What the hell? Did you see that? Okay, now, the thing is, up here, there's water, which would normally mean you can't do this, but it's actually possible to get up into the area, if you just jump through the door, you can make this jump and get up here way early. And there's two pickups up here, which could be hugely big. Yeah, it's the charge beam. Nice. Don't want to miss that. And what's in here? Missiles. Miskles. Now, getting out of here might be a bit of an issue, but... like, I've come up here, like, earlier than this before, because the thing is, you can't really avoid the boulders on the way out. Which is kind of annoying. Also, getting out of here is a pain in the ass. Oop. You have to, like, basically just... ugh. Man, what a pain in my ass. You have to, like, jump out of here, somewhere called out of here, when the water is at its absolute lowest, and get that wall jump off in, like, the split second you have. Oh, I'm gonna have just enough power bombs to get out of here, too. Oh, man. That could have been really bad. If I had used up one less power bomb and not realized that I didn't have enough, I would have been stuck, and I would have had a soft reset already. Well, not even soft reset. I would have had to start the whole game over. I gotta be... That's the thing about these randomizers. You gotta be more careful about that. Because otherwise, you'll die! Or, like... well, I guess... realistically, you would die. Samus would eventually waste away because you wouldn't be able to eat. She'd just be stuck there for literally ever. You know, if I had some more power bomb... ooh. Excuse me. Ugh, acid reflux. If I had a couple more power bombs, I could go right into Breen Grinstar right now without even going through criteria again. Speaking of, please drop some power bombs. I know, like, power drums are kind of a premium drop. Like, you don't get them from just any enemy, but seriously, like... I mean, I guess I got the charge beam. That's better than nothing, but it certainly isn't that impressive. Oh man, you know what else I'm excited for? Dragon Quest Builders coming to Switch, because that's awesome. Like, because I've always wanted to play Dragon Quest Builders, but I've never had a, I don't have a PS4 or a PS3 or any of this or anything of the sort. And I'm probably gonna end up eventually getting a PS4 anyway, because I want to get, like, you know, Dark Souls 3, stuff like that, Persona 5. But it's nice because I'll definitely get a Switch first. Which means it's cool that Dragon Quest Builders is coming to the Switch, because it means I can play it sooner, ostensibly. I mean, I have, like, literally zero income, so... because I'm a hopeless idiot who has, like, no competencies at all. Now, you have to be careful here. I really wish I could get a power bomb drop. But it looks like that's not gonna happen. Here, you know what let's do? Let's actually save. Let's save it, like, any opportunity we get. This is not a save point. So that I don't end up in a situation where I'm stuck and have to start the whole fucking game over. Because I would, and normally I would just rewind. But I don't really feel like doing that. I don't usually say da to the song, usually I say ba, but like when I sing along to it, you know? There's pretty much like a few ways, you know, you can hum, you can go da, or you can go ba, or you can go ha or something, or like la. Of all the consonants I use to sing along to this song, I don't usually pick D. This is just a map. I don't know why I'm even coming in here for. Oh, I should have tried to do the trick. I've actually gotten pretty good at doing that trick, where you pause, right before you hit the thing, and then you run out of the room before the pop-up can appear and force you into the map screen. It's basically the trick. Oh, you know what I can do? I can just go to my ship and refill my power bombs. Okay, that'll do. That'll do, pig. Yeah, I've gotten pretty good at doing that trick where you like if an energy recharge station or a map station, you pause the game. You hit start like right before you hit the station, and then like the game pauses, because the mistake I kept making was I was trying to hit start like right after, I touched the map station, but you're supposed to do it, like, right before. So that you can actually, so that the screen starts fading to black, and then you attach yourself to the map station, then you unpause, then it pauses, then you unpause, then you run for the door, then the pop-up that appears that says map storage, or like map data downloaded or whatever, and then you get out the door before it opens the map and you don't waste more time. It saves a little bit of time. I'm about to fight the bomb guardian with power bombs. How odd is that? And it's just missiles. Oh, actually, they don't make you fight the bomb guardian in the randomizer, which is really weird. I've never understood why they don't make you fight the bomb guardian. It's not like you need an item to beat him. You can just shoot him. You know? Like, there's literally no reason why you could ever become stuck in that room. It's why it really baffles me that they don't make you fight the bomb guardian. Although I do worry a bit that they're gonna make me wait like a really long time before they give me regular bombs. I'm coming out here to refill my power bombs because you really can never be too careful. When you have a limited supply of bombs, you gotta refill it at every chance you get. Otherwise, it's really easy to get stuck and you get fucked over. Whoa! And obviously, since I don't have bombs, I also can't bomb jump. That's gonna be a pain. Well, it's not really gonna be that much of a pain, but I was thinking of like, hey, I have power bombs. Why don't I go up to that door in the upper left, in the upper right corner of the spawn area? But no, you can't, because you can't get in there. I can't get up there. Because you basically need to have like a really, really good jump. But wait, no, this is the safe point. You need the ability to ascend. I don't have the ability to ascend right now, not beyond my regular jump at least, which isn't enough, obviously. What we got here. You gotta check. This is the thing I love about randomizers. You have to check every single item pedestal, because any item pedestal could be the one that has the thing you're looking for, and you have no fucking idea. Unless you, like, get the spoiler log, which I believe is what that does. It just shows you, like, it just tells you, like, where all the important items are, probably. I don't know. I never check that box on the randomizer because I'm not interested in spoilers. Man, you know what else drives me crazy about the gaming community these days? Is how fucking insane people are about making sure they know nothing about a game before they play it. Like, do you know how many games I've played 100% blind in my life? Few games. And you know what? I enjoyed them just as much. Like, as long as you don't just read a list of spoilers, experiencing a game's plot secondhand is no less rewarding than experiencing it yourself. Like, why would it be? You're still seeing the same plot. It's not any different because you're playing it. Oh, I feel more of a connection. Oh, well, there you go. The people go so fucking crazy over spoilers. And, like, I understand sometimes, like, when boss guides go up on, like, GameSpot or Game Informer or whatever on YouTube, and they put, like, the true secret final boss in the thumbnail, that's fucking stupid. But people seriously need to calm their tits when it comes to spoilers. It drives me absolutely crazy. Hip. I think I did that right. Can I nail this? Yes, I can! First try! Fuck yeah. And it's just miskles. I don't know why I keep saying miskles. It's like muscles, but it's not. It's missiles. Oh, I need to use a power bomb here. And it's more miskulls. Man, I'm getting a lot of miskulls. Stop saying miskulls! You're so stupid! Jeez! But yeah, and even like especially when people are like, I can also understand, like, not, oh, I don't want to see story spoilers. But like, people seriously overrate the value of surprise, you know? Like, people fucking care more about not knowing anything about a game than making sure they're actually gonna like a game before they buy it. It's so stupid. Like, people complaining that, oh, Nintendo shows too much stuff in the Nintendo Directs. Oh, they're not showing, they're showing all the worlds in Mario Odyssey. Get over yours. Like, who cares? The game is still gonna be fun. Just because you don't, just because you know what the worlds are gonna be before you play the game doesn't mean the game, doesn't mean the game's gonna be any less fun. Like, how many people knew, like, the worlds of Banjo-Kazooie? There you go, I just did the trick. How many people in the game, how many people in the world played Banjo-Kazooie without knowing what any of the worlds were first? And did it hurt their experience? No, because the game's charm doesn't come from not knowing what's coming. It comes from the what's in the fucking game, you know? It's almost like, it's almost, it almost feels rude to the developers to value not knowing anything about the game before you buy it more than you value the actual content of the game. It's like you're not even buying it for what they did, you're just buying it because it's an IP that you want to play a new game of, and you don't care about any of this, and you don't want any spoilers because you want to make sure your game experience is absolutely 100% untainted. I forget where I was going with this. What's over here? I'll tell you what's over here: a hopper that is in, that is going absolutely insane with its hopping. Yeah, I feel like it's reached a point where it's become overkill. The whole reaction craze needs to be put to rest. People need to get over it. Power bombs, nice. More power bombs. Ah, yummy! Fresh meat for my pocket. And missiles. Disrespectful, that's the word I was looking for, not rude. Fucking rude. Jeez, what are you, like an 8-year-old? What are you, like a Midwestern mom? It's really rude to the developers. Stupid. Anyway. But yeah, that's just my two cents. Take it or leave it. I mean, somebody's even watching this video anyway. So who cares? That's the kind of thing that everybody has, that everybody in the gaming community pretty much has an opinion on, though. Which is cool. Because it basically means you can always get a discussion out of it just by bringing it up. Now, whether or not that's a good discussion remains to be seen, obviously, but... Should I come in here? I mean, I can kill the guy in here with a power bomb, but... Somebody's walking around upstairs and they're making a big old racket. Da-da. I can kill the guy in here with a power bomb, but I'm still afraid of him because he does, because he'll do 40 damage with a single hit. Just take hits from the little guys. Okay, that was good. Oh, no, I can't do this. I need the fucking wave beam. What am I doing? Jeez. I always forget that you need the wave beam there, because normally you have the wave beam before you get power bombs. Like, seriously. I'm also not 100% sure of the safety of going into... There's obviously that secret passage. By that missile pack I picked up that I wall-jumped to. How the hell... That is, like, the first time I've ever made it to the end of that hallway without taking damage. Of course, I took a hit, like, a second later, but... Well, I'm still impressed. I'm still amazed that I managed to get through there without getting hit for that long. Those hoppers are usually really hard to avoid. Does anybody else do that? They just start hearing, like, just the slap bass or whatever that is? That, like, twanging, badass guitar. Man, I gotta use 2 power bombs to get in and out of that save room. That is ridiculous, man. I'm saving my super missiles for spore spawn. Also, get rid of these guys with some some good old missiles. You know what's weird about this spore spawn fight is that it doesn't lock you in with a fully locked door. It locks you in with a green door. So if you already have super missiles, you can actually, like, bail out of this fight, which is kind of funny. I wonder if it's possible to get power bomb drops from these spores. You know what I never realized before? There's actually... These spores aren't just randomly raining down. There's actually, like... I wonder if you can actually, like, destroy those maybe in some way. Let's try and use a power bomb here. Okay, that didn't hit him. I hope I didn't just screw myself by using that power bomb. Because I very well could have. Oh, you know what? I have to use missiles. I can't afford to use super missiles. Because you need two super missiles to get out of here. So if I use up all my super missiles, I'll be trapped. So definitely don't let that happen. Because you don't need bombs to get out of here, but you do need super missiles. Actually, I might need a power bomb. I might be screwed here. Oh, but you know what? He'll probably drop a power bomb when he dies, because these bosses drop all sorts of junk. As long as I have one power bomb and some super missiles, I can get out of here. This is what you gotta watch out for, man. Stuff like this. I can't believe I've gotten 3 hits on this guy every single volley. Like, that's crazy. Normally, it's really hard to hit this guy with more than one missile. Actually, I wonder if I could, like, charge. Like, get a charge beam shot. Hit him with that. I wonder how much damage that would do. That does, like, relative to, like, what else I have. Ow. Open up. This is the police. Thank you. Aha, you died. I like it that you died, because you died. Okay, thank you for dropping a power bomb. Make me nervous, man. Make me nervous. I'm a long way from my ship, so I can't get any refills. I shouldn't have been using them all willy-nilly. I just wanted to see if you could kill those spore guys. Those spore spawners. It's weird that he's called spore spawn, but the thing spawning the spores is these little bulbs on the ceiling. Like, what? And missiles. Missile, 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 go. You aren't gonna get any of that in this LP, really. Yeah, I shouldn't have worried so much about using up my super missiles, because he would have dropped more. I mean, he did drop more. It's not a question of would have, he did. Thank goodness he dropped a power bomb, though, because otherwise I would have been, well, actually, if he hadn't dropped a power bomb, I would have just not gone down and gotten that missile pack. Should I go for 100%? I feel like I probably should, but at the same time, it's frisky business. I hate that area right there, because it's almost impossible to avoid taking a hit there. I'm not even sure, like, how you're supposed to do that. Maybe just, like, shoot him before he can hit you? Grapple beam? Well, hell. All we need is the x-ray scope, and we've got everything. Well, except the gravity suit. And the speed booster. Okay, like, every kind of weapon that you can cycle through, that's what I meant to say. Not every item in the game, but obviously, because we don't have the screw attack, we don't have the space jump. We don't have any of the reserve tanks. We're missing a couple dozen super missile packs. Oh yeah, these guys drop super missiles, which is nice. These cactus guys. remember in the randomizer race? I haven't even mentioned this yet, but yeah. I haven't done a randomizer race on my channel, but I did race Super Metroid with KyleFish64. And, I remember me and him got into, we got into a debate over whether or not these guys were in fact cactus monsters. And I was saying, no, they just look like cactuses and they shoot thorns, but they're not actually cactuses. But I looked it up on the wiki, and their name is actually like Cactoid or something, which is really funny. Oh, you know what? Oh, shoot, I can't kill this guy, though. Yes, I can! Yeah, these guys drop power bombs. That's nice. And you guys drop super missiles. That's even more nice. I've never grinded off these guys on the side before. I never really registered this, but all those enemies that you see coming out of the pipes in the ground, these are just the same thing, but they come out of the wall. That's interesting. Also, seems to be not interested in dropping any more. Okay, so dropping down into lower Brinstar has always been risky. Is it possible for me to back? No, it's not possible. I went past the gate. I can't backtrack anymore. It is possible to actually climb up this shaft without the ice beam. It's a pain in the ass, but it's totally possible. I think you might need the high jump boots, but man, whatever. Oh, here's this part. Oh man, this is. I played Super Metroid recently with guests over. Like, we were having, like, a party or something, and I just played Super Metroid to, like, pass the time, and I died in this area. I got caught by that little jaw guy. Hold on. I am not going through here without knowing whether or not I can destroy that with a blaster shot, because it would that would be a really easy way to get trapped. I'll tell you right now, yeah, I got caught by that guy, and he got me stuck in the ground, and I just couldn't recover from it. I was stuck in there, and I died. It was really embarrassing. Especially because I was trying to show off how cool the game was. Like, that was kind of like, oh, look at this game, isn't this a cool game? But unfortunately, it was not to be. Do I go down to Norfair? I guess I go down to Norfair. I got the Varia suit, so I can pretty much go wherever the hell I want. There's another area down here that you need to be careful about, though. The area that you go to get the high jump boots, if you actually go in there and you don't have any power and you don't have any bombs to get back, you can get stuck. Because you need bombs to get out, but not to get in. I really wish, like, literally anybody in this game would drop power bombs with any modicum of regular. What is going on? Is it just the wind outside, maybe? Maybe it's just the wind. I do need power bombs to get out of there. Okay, no, don't go there. Don't go anywhere where you need. Don't go anywhere where you that you need bombs to get out of, unless you actually have power bombs. That's a really easy way to get fucked over. Do you drop power bombs? Yes, you do. How nice. You also do a lot of damage. Holy crap. That guy does a lot of damage. Ranboot. Dude, would you quit lagging, man? Seriously. Oh, you can make that jump, Samus. Come on, girl. What are you doing? Oh, shit. Do I need to use a bomb to get out of here? Tell you what, I wasn't prepared for those like hairy guys to do that much damage. Also, I don't know if I can get up out of here. Okay. I don't think I can get up there. I mean, I probably can, but I don't want to try. Dude, would you quit lagging? You're driving me crazy, man. I mean, I know these areas in Norfair are hell on my processor. Because of the moving background, it makes the file size of the video, like, significantly bigger. But use a power bomb. Let's get down here. I think a good use of this power bomb would be to open up the save point. Just don't trap yourself. That's the big thing. Just don't trap yourself. There's no recovering from that. Oh, this is the map. We got the map. See you, morons. I did it. Oh, shoot him. Sheesh. I'm glad these guys drop energy regularly, because that would also be bad. I should check this area here. The area right before the area with the high jump boots. Because it's just missiles. Jeez. Oh no! Nope, that's fine. He'll eventually come back. Does that reform? I forgot that this door locks behind you. I have to kill. Yeah. Is he gonna come back eventually? He has to, right? Oh, there's the save point. Oh, I'm such an idiot. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, jeez. Oh, making me nervous, man. Let's save. I'll not be a fucking idiot. Look at the map that you just got. See where the save point is. Not difficult. Okay, I think it's time to go to Kraid's hideout. I worry that I've, like, missed some item that's supposed to be easy to get to. You know? I mean, the good thing about Kraid's hideout is there's a whole room full of those guys. Those, like, hoppy grasshopper dudes that drop power bombs. There's a whole room of those guys that I can grind power bombs off of. This is the trial of the randomizer, of the Super Metroid randomizer. Not getting bombs and then having to really try to ration your power bombs. Because if you run out of power bombs and you get stuck, that's it. You know, you have to reload a save. Or use, like, the rewind function on your emulator. which is definitely, like, an option. You know, for the longest time, I thought only the bottom block here was destructible. It was only very recently I found out you can actually break open any of those. There we go. That's not that hard of a jump to make, but, well, yeah. You guys drop missiles and shit. Thankfully, what? Oh, man, really? Really, though? Really? I forgot, that door is locked until you beat Kraid. Good grief, man, where the hell am I gonna go? I'm running out of places. Like, seriously. Ugh, get out of here. I wonder if you can kill these guys with, like, a super missile. Yes, you can. Do they drop anything good? Like, power bombs? Just energy, so far. Not impressed. Hey, can I... What happens if I charge up and then curl up into a ball? Okay, if I don't have bombs, that actually just keeps the charge. That's interesting. Because what you can do if you have bombs, I guess, only if you have bombs, apparently, is charge up your charge beam and then go into a ball, and it'll release, like, a spray of bombs. But apparently that doesn't work if you don't have bombs, which makes sense, but I think you can kill these guys with a super missile. They don't drop anything, though. Jeez. Energy, energy, energy. I don't need energy. You also want energy? Energy! Ah! Just running all the time! Power lifting, power running, power speeding, power dating, power spawning babies. I'll have so many babies. 400 babies. Okay, these guys drop super missiles, and I'm full on energy, so you better drop something good. You son of a fuck. Oh boy. Oh no. I might be stuck here, guys. Wait a second. What about this? Because there's an area you can jump up through the ceiling here. Maybe it's on the other side. And it leads up into Meridia, where you can... Yeah. No? Yeah, here we go. Yeah, there's enemies here, and these guys might drop more stuff. Well, just energy, apparently. But... Oh, come on. Don't do me dirty like this. There we go, yes! Oh man, I can grind power bombs here. Now what the hell is this? This is like the most granular edition of Super Metroid I think I've ever played in my life. I'm grinding for power bombs on an enemy spawner in the area of Meridia you can get to from the pipe area in Brinstar. That guy only took one hit. Do these guys actually, like, inherit HP from the last one to despawn? That'd be weird. Yeah, there we go. Just charge the charge beam here. And let it loose. Dude, you gotta drop some more power bombs, man. Oh, man. What? Why'd you only drop one power bomb? Dude! Oh my gosh! What? Why do you only drop one power bomb? That's so much bull hunts! Okay, you know what let's do? Let's see if I can kill this guy. We can damage him. I didn't even know you could damage these guys. Yep, four hits from a super missile will kill those guys. Interesting. The things you learn by playing a randomizer, being, like, literally at the end of your rope when it comes to, like, what items you need to get. Okay, you need to start dropping some super missiles now. Dude! Maybe if I zone out and zone back in. Because now I'm out of super missiles, now I can't get into Kraid's hideout, which means I can't go and fight Kraid, which means I can't possibly get drops from Kraid, that would allow me to do this. There we go. Getting into this with a somersault can be kind of tricky too, but obviously it's not really a problem. I don't know why this thing suddenly stopped dropping shit before. Dude, what the heck? Okay, there we go. Seriously, this is ridiculous. Thank you for the Super Metroid drops. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And you're done dropping stuff. Okay, so I guess those guys only drop power bombs if you have literally no power bombs. That's annoying. But anyway, let's not waste two super missiles getting through that door this time, eh? Dude, you've got to stop lagging, man. You're driving me crazy. And my throat isn't helping either. My throat's being a little bitch. Thanks for the powerbomb drop. Wait. Fuck. Okay, hang on. Hold the phone. Turn back. Go save in Norfair just in case you don't get a powerbomb drop and have to go all the way back. I'm gonna try and absolutely minimize the number of resets I have to do here. What I really should do is just assign a rewind key to my controller. Not be a fucking idiot. But I want to do this legit, man. My throat apparently does not, because holy crap, are you hearing that shit? I'll do this legit, man. It's not like I've been smoking like 20 packs a day for the last 40 years. Anyway. Not really, obviously. I have no idea what that's like, but... jeez, I certainly sound hoarse enough. Because I got this weird thing at the back of my throat, it feels like I've got, like, a piece of popcorn stuck back there. And I think it's actually just, like a little cut in, like, my gums back there. Like, at the back of my throat, there's, like, a little laceration that just feels like... there's, like, a piece of corn husk. You know, like, the... you know, like, when you pop a popcorn kernel, you still got those, like... those little tough bits that are kind of like the core of an apple, you know? It feels like I've got a piece of a core of an apple or a tough piece of popcorn stuck in the back of my throat. So that sucks. Anyway. I appreciate you guys dropping super missiles. Oh, you motherfucker! I have to... oh my gosh! I have to go back out, go back to the area in Meridia, grind power bombs, get a power bomb, come back here, go through there. Man, what a pain in the dick. Okay, drop a power bomb. No, a power bomb. No, a power bomb. No, a power bomb. The lid. The lid. The lid. The lid. Dude. Drop something. My life or death hinges on you fucking dropping your shit. You've done it before. What the hell? Oh my gosh, are you fucking joking right now? I don't have time for this. It's Tuesday. Yeah, it's Tuesday. For some reason, I thought it was Saturday. It's because I'm thinking, like, of the time I'm gonna upload this, which is gonna be on a Saturday. Because Saturday's my whatever date. Would you quit hitting me? Grr! It's just taking up space that could be taken up by powerbomb drops. Motherfuck! What the hell is wrong with this thing? Why is it not dropping powerbombs all of a sudden? Dude! Cough. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Gah! Give me one power bomb. I only need one! 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 You know what? Fuck this shit. I'm gonna go get him from the hairy hoppers in Norfair. I had him down to one that time. I had him down to one. I had him down to one. I should do Castlevania 1 one of these days. That'd be funny. You think this rage is bad? You just wait until you see me playing that game. Good grief. I wonder if I could get in there with a wall jump and not have to use a powerbomb on the way out of here. Because these guys... Yeah, shoot him with a... Really? They take more than one missile to kill? And he didn't even drop him. Stop lagging! Fucking... Fuck, damn it! Okay, I can totally make it up here. Oh, well, dude! Maybe if you actually did the fucking wall jump... I cannot believe how much it is lagging in this stupid area. Dude! And it's actually, like, it's the kind of lag that causes your button inputs to not go in, too. Like, I've had problems with this emulator before, but seriously. Okay, I can make it out of here without spending a powerbomb. That means I can grind in here to my heart's content. What I really should do is just cut to when I have enough powerbombs. Like, if I was a responsible LP here, that's what I would do, but... Two missiles to kill these guys. Okay, there we go. We have found a way to regularly acquire power bombs. We could have something big here. We have three power bombs. We can get in and out of Kraid's hideout, no problem, with three power bombs. Let's save, go up there. I've wasted like 20 minutes on this horse shit. Good grief, I'm gonna take a drink of this hard iced tea I have sitting here. It was so much better a week ago. Not that that's been sitting there outside in it. Not that that's been sitting there for a week. It's just that the can of hard iced tea is from a can. We got the package a week ago at least. Okay. Three power bombs. Super missiles to spare, lots of missiles, various suit, let's go, Kraid, here we go. And you guys will drop more super missiles. Or not, you'll just drop regular ones because you're a piece of shit. But yeah, three power bombs is enough to get in and out of this area, no problem. And like, yeah, I could have come in here before, just in case any of the enemies in here actually wanted to drop power bombs, but I couldn't take that risk, you know, obviously. I really wish I had the X-ray scope, you know? Well, you know, I have three power bombs. That means I can use one on the... Well, no, you might be forgetting something. Never underestimate that I have punches. Never underestimate that I can forget things. Possible to happen. Don't walk past a drop. Ow. Yep, just a bunch of super missiles. As I expected. Man, what I wouldn't give for this to be playing like Metroid Fusion right now, where they have those like red X parasites that give you like that completely replenish you when you open a boss door. Oh, these guys drop power bombs! Well, okay, these guys dropped one power bomb. Which shows that it is possible, but who knows how likely it is. I got a lot of missiles. Dude, I don't need more missiles, you need power bombs. I think I'm gonna end the first part after I fight Kraid. I was thinking I was gonna do the whole playthrough right now, but I don't think that's feasible. I think that would just be too much of a pain in the ass. Just kick your ass. I'm here, Kraid. I don't have the high jump boot, so this is gonna be a pain in the ass, but well, that's just the way the toast sometimes. Da ba 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 da 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 da. This music is so fucking good. I can't even get over it. Man, he's so chunky. He's like a, he's such a large man. No. Dude, your fucking hand got in the way. Jeez. Like first you don't open your hand for like 10 seconds longer than you're supposed to. And then when you finally do, your hand blocks my shot. What a cockatripe. Okay, I think if I just get like a couple more shots here, I'll beat him. Yeah, just one more missile. Ow. Oh, there we go. Lots of power bombs. Oh my gosh, so many power bombs. I'm at 8. 8 power bombs. Oh, it feels so good. Oh shit, space jump. Hot dog. Awesome. Awesome, man. Oh, you know what? Space jump is a real is a pain in the ass to use with the high jump boots though. It doesn't work nearly as well, but still. Space jump. Damn, B. I mean, it's pretty much, it's more of a convenience thing, but still. Yeah, real fake Crane, get out of here. Oh no, Crane! Oh no, fake Crane! Oh no, real fake Crane! Now that I got the space jump, I want to keep going. But I can't seriously do that. I gotta get like some tea or something. Because my throat's killing me. Dude, would you guys get the fuck out of here? Ugh. How are you still alive? Fuck. And no ice cream! Fuck! Yeah, that's worth it. I mean, I got the power bombs to spare now. Of course, I'm gonna regret saying that in 5 minutes. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna end the first recording here, because I feel like the longer I go with this, the more lag I'm gonna get. So, yeah. I'm gonna end the first recording here. Yeah. Super Metroid Randomized. I guess this is gonna be a multi-part Saturday special. That's good. Finally gets this up put on Saturdays. Anyway, yeah, I'll see you guys next time when we will leave Crane's Hideout and probably go down to Norfair. Bye!